I have not lost faith and hope. Some voice was coming from my heart, go ahead, go ahead, go ahead, things will happen. So I went, and it was very difficult, very hard.
What was the timeline, if you may like to talk about it, if you can talk about the timeline when it all that idea came and then you started work, setting up this Mahabodhi International Meditation Center and then building around so many things.
Right from the beginning it still continues but different ways. Yeah, at the beginning different, but now maybe before at the beginning establishing, raising funds, establishing, even having training people to carry this new concept. This traditionally Buddhist monks do not get involved in social service, humanitarian services. Traditionally, not only in Buddhism, Hinduism and everywhere, traditionally monks and nuns remain confined to monastic life, conducting prayer, rite, rituals, ceremonies, preachings. Never get involved in starting a school or hospital, in ornamental projects, this kind of big program, no. So I have to train my people to understand this, and it was not easy for me. You see, my ideas lofty, my ideas international, and my staff, local people, have not seen beyond this the mountain around. So it was challenging at the beginning. Now running of that also different. The challenges goes, but very often time it comes to my mind, it's enough now. Now you have to take care of yourself, go to mountains, spend the rest of life in a cave, so many times. And then slowly also come the other side, yes, you are suffering, you have difficulties, but the number of people with me and maybe few more people with me, going through difficulties, challenges, lot of difficulties, compared to the number of people who are benefiting, underfed village, sick people, poor people, ignorant people, benefiting from meditation, yoga, spiritual teachings, education, medical, other things. The number of people who are benefiting from the organization, it's much more, no comparison with the number of people who are going through these challenges, difficulties. So, and I then I feel, it comes to my mind, it's worth sacrificing yourself, sacrificing the smaller number for the cause of bigger numbers. The people, number of people who benefit is countless, and the number of people who are going through some challenges, difficulties, so small, just few.
आपने अभी थोड़ी देर पहले जब यहाँ पे आपने अपने भाषण में भी कहा कि योगा और मेडिटेशन दो अलग अलग चीज़ नहीं है, दोनों एक दूसरे के पूरक है या दोनों एक दूसरे में ही हैं, उसके बारे में थोड़ा बताएं।
यस, ओरिजिनली योगा मीन्स मेडिटेशन, व्हाट दिस मीन योग मीन्स योगा और योग मीन्स यूनाइटिंग, गेटिंग कनेक्शन, गेटिंग यूनाइटेड, connection with whom, uniting with whom, with the ultimate truth, you can say with God, the universal consciousness, ultimate truth. That is the thing. Initially, originally, yoga means meditation, then slowly change. Now yoga became more focused on body, now yoga means making your body strong, healthy. Meditation means making the mind healthy, concentrating. But originally yoga means meditation, so no much difference.
एक सरल जिंदगी, एक अच्छी जिंदगी जीने के लिए what all one needs to practice, आपके विचार से, एक जो भागदौड़ की जिंदगी है शहरों में, जो अब छोटे छोटे शहरों में भी भागदौड़ की जिंदगी, वहाँ ठहरे कैसे, वहाँ रुके कैसे, how to hold self, how to stop and rethink. We have stopped thinking, we have just become mechanical. How do you explain those problems which are existing? How do you feel, what is the suggestion or advice that you would like to give to people?
Yes, what we see in modern cities, actually modern cities, as you mentioned, life is becoming like machines. they have no time to think, and they just follow the already established stream of society. If everybody is running that direction, people are running. Every children are going to school to learn something, they follow. Everybody is looking for a job, yeah. Everybody is trying to earn money more than others, they are doing. Everybody is trying to have better than others, that is what they are doing. As a result, people are gaining all the material requirement, better house, better car, more money, status, but they are losing human values. The beauty of human life, mental peace, mental purity, and the understanding, you know, natural value thing is losing. So for that, what they have to do is really, we need to have more program. Like you have so much program, so many training, studies, workshop, all kinds of activities, how to make more money, how to make better house, bigger house, even more than what you need. So certainly for the poor people who don't have roti kapda makan, this is a perfect teaching. Without roti kapda makan, you can't think of even spirituality. Poverty, illiteracy, also source of suffering. You have to have first that. After that, then one have to realize that the ultimate happiness, ultimate well-being does not come from material, from money. With money you can buy pillow, but you cannot buy sleep. With money you can buy furniture, you cannot buy relaxation on that. So we have to understand how to draw a line between the need and the greed. Now, actually people in the cities are developing greed, but they don't use the word greed. In place of greed, they use need, development. When you hear the need, when you hear the development, you agree, okay. But if you look carefully, yes, this is a development. But what kind of development? It's a development of greed. That is the cause, the problem. So we have to have program, we have to educate people. No, in our order, they must be in balance. Unless it is in balance, humanity will never be able to enjoy complete happiness and peace. This balance is missing. All are totally focused on external things, physical part of our life, material part of things. People think that if you have better house, this is wrong, that you can ask those who have.
So if I may ask one very personal question, what brought you to spirituality, and what one idea that made you feel that, yes, I want to be a bhikshu, or I want to get into spirituality?
Yeah, there's maybe two few different reasons. One maybe reason, my past life, because since childhood I was constantly searching, looking, thinking, searching something, I'm not satisfied with what exists. Whenever I get little time, I used to get lost in the kind of thinking, who is behind all this creation? Why all this difference? Some are poor, some are rich, some are intelligent, some are foolish, some are beautiful, some are ugly, some are very loving, kind, some are very cruel. Why? Who is this? What is the reason, or who is behind this creation? I was always thinking, searching, praying, and sometimes I used to ask people, they will laugh at me. I used to ask that whether it is human being, animals or trees, they grow from a small tiny seed and then keep on growing, and after time it stops. Wait, who stops? Who is that? When we grow since childhood, why it doesn't continue to grow? Why it stopped
there?
Why it stopped? All kinds of things. If I ask this question, people will laugh. They think something wrong with me, crazy, I have gone crazy. So I even cannot ask this question. What I used to do is just go to a place and then cry myself. Tears were coming from my eyes, not finding the answer. And when I came in contact at the age of, I served in Indian Army 4.5 years. Then I came in contact with the Buddhist monk, though I was born and brought up in Buddhist families, but my actual knowledge of Buddhism was not there. By name, by tradition, by culture, we were Buddhist. And I came in contact with the Buddhist monk and mindfully tried to hear from that monk, well, who was the Buddha, what is his life story, what is basic teaching. I realized, wow, that is what I've been looking. I said, is it too late for me to quit this military life and join the monastery to become a monk? He said, yes, there is no time fix. The gate of Dharma, gate of monastery open eternally. Those who are ready, those who are ready, those who are really seriously interested. I was so happy. I was not too old at 21. Perfect age to enter the monastery. Before 20, you cannot actually. You can invite as a novice student, but not as a full ordained monk. So I immediately left the army and joined the monastery. When I joined the monastery, I felt coming back home. That's what I've been looking. I was so happy, so happy. That's one reason. And then, of course, I see a lot of problems. One is coming, the thought coming from, you know, previous life, I feel. Secondly, I see a lot of chaos, confused problem already. Was able to notice, but it's not very clear.